Oh, hello, there we are.
Let's try this again. As we celebrate the baptism of our Lord, please stand and welcome those around you by way of introduction safely. Our opening hymn can be found in the blue book, number 583, Wade in the Water, number 583.
To celebrate with the community here at St. Stephen's. My name is Father Juan Gaspar. I'm the Director of Formation for the Pre-Novices at the Shrine. We're a religious order and we have seminarians. And to my left, I have Brother Max, who's visiting. He's from Cameroon, but he's studying in San Antonio. And so we're delighted to be able to share this liturgy as we finish off the Christmas season, right? So let us be mindful of God's presence in our midst, and let us sign us by the sign of our gift. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
As we hear in the scriptures today, we're reminded of our identity given to us by our Savior Christ. And one of the greatest gifts that we have to embrace is that no matter how many times we mess up, we're called to reconcile with God the Father, with ourselves, and with our neighbors. To celebrate these sacred mysteries, let us ask God's mercy.
I confess to Almighty God, and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Glory to God. We adore you, we glorify you, we give you thanks for your great glory, Lord God, Heavenly King. O God, Almighty Father, Lord Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God. Mercy on us. Take away the sins of the world. We see our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. For you alone are the Holy One. You alone.
Let us pray. Almighty, ever-living God, who when Christ had been baptized in the River Jordan, and as the Holy Spirit descended upon him, solemnly declared him your beloved Son, grant that your children by adoption, reborn of water and the Holy Spirit, may always be well pleasing to you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Comfort, give comfort to my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem, and proclaim to her that her service is at an end. Her guilt is expiated. Indeed, she has received from the hand of the Lord double for all her sins. A voice cries out in the desert, prepare the way of the Lord, make straight in the wasteland a highway for our God. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill shall be made low. The rugged land shall be made a plain, the rough country a broad valley. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all people shall see it together. For the mouth of the Lord has spoken. Go up onto a high mountain, Zion, herald of glad tidings. Cry out at the top of your voice, Jerusalem, herald of good news. Fear not to cry out, and say to the cities of Judah, here is your God. Here comes with power the Lord God, who rules by a strong arm. Here is his reward with him, his recompense before him. Like a shepherd, he feeds his flock. In his arms, he gathers the lambs, carrying them in his bosom and leading the ewes with care. The word of the Lord.
Thank you.
Lord, send out your spirit and renew out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Lord, my God, you are great indeed. How manifold are your works, O Lord? The earth is full of your creatures. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. If you take away their breath, they die, and they return to their dust. When you send forth your spirit of life, they are created in your song. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. May his glory last for all time. May the Lord be glad in his works. Pleasing to him will be my theme. I will be glad in the Lord. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth. Lord, send out your spirit and renew the face of the earth.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to Titus. Beloved, the grace of God has appeared, saving all and training us to reject godless ways and worldly desires, and to live temperately, justly, and devout in this age. As we await the blessed hope, the appearance of the glory of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ, who called a people as his own, eager to do what is good. When the kindness and generous love of God, our Savior, appeared, not because of any righteous deeds we had done, but because of his mercy, he saved us through the bath of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom he richly poured out on us through Jesus Christ, our Savior, so that we might be justified by his grace and become heirs in hope of eternal life. The word of the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. The people were filled with expectation and all were asking in their hearts whether John might be the Christ. John answered them all saying,
I am baptizing you with water, but with his sandals, he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. All the people have been baptized, and Jesus also had been baptized and was praying. Heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove. And a voice came from heaven. You are my beloved Son. With you I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
It is just a piece of paper, a teenage girl said to her father, referring to a marriage license. What difference does a piece of paper make? Recent surveys indicate that a disturbing number of young adults in our society are living together without the benefit of wedlock. It is just a ceremony, they say. What has a ceremony got to do with love? This is the spirit of our time now. Not every young person has this attitude toward marriage. The wife of a Baptist minister told us about a young couple who came with a marriage license. On the license was a blank space indicating the number of marriages of each person. The young man entered the word first. The young woman entered the word last. What difference does a ceremony make? Our readings are not about marriage, but about baptism. Jesus came to be baptized by his cousin, John the Baptist. Baptism was and is a rite widely practiced among the ancient people of that time. It was also employed as an initiation rite. Sound familiar? This is a way of making public notice of the intent to be part of a group. You and I waded in the water and were immersed. It varies in procedure from one location to another. Because Jesus underwent this act of initiation, every Christian denomination has set baptism as a central requirement of our Christian faith. We may differ in its application. We may differ in how baptism is applied. Requirement of the kingdom of God. In John's gospel, Jesus says to us, "Truly, truly, I say to you, unless one is born of water and spirit, you cannot enter the kingdom of God." Baptism is a requirement of discipleship. We will all agree, we will all argue as to whether it is just a ceremony, but are not our ceremonies important as when we salute a flag? Or exchange rings and vows before the altar, or present a child before the congregation and before God in an act of dedication and commitment. Ceremonies are an act of community. Many people have contributed to our being where we are today. We did not come into the world by ourselves. We did not come into the Christian faith by ourselves. We are interrelated whether we like it or not. We are part of a family. Baptism is an act of community. Except in the direst of circumstances, it should never be performed in private. The person who says, "I can be a Christian without church," does not understand the nature of Christian life. When we become sons and daughters of the Father, we become brothers and sisters to one another. If you or I were stranded on a desert island, we could still be a Christian. But if we seek to be an island unto ourselves in the middle of society, we cannot be a Christian. Some of you may remember a country and western song with these lyrics. Me and Jesus got a good thing going. Me and Jesus got it all worked out. Well, really? Without the church, there would be no good news to give meaning to our lives. We receive the gospel because other people were willing to give their lives for it, their wealth, their sons and daughters, to tell the story. Baptism is an act of community. It signifies that we are becoming a part of the family of God. Of humility, an act of repentance. A false pride may tell us that we are too good to need baptism. Maybe we are. The only requirement to avoid the need for baptism is that we be better than Jesus. If I stand up here and say that I am superior to the Son of God, then there is no need for me to have been baptized. But if I confess that I do not know all of what God means for me to be, then I stand in the need of the means of grace, baptism. Maybe we are not the men and women we intended to be. Certainly, none of us are all God intends us to be. It is a good thing that perfection is not a requirement for baptism. Baptism is an admission of our need for God's mercy and grace. Baptism is an acknowledgement that there is a flaw in our character. If we were a society of saints, we would not need baptism, for that matter, marriage. Ceremonies remind us of both responsibilities and realities. Do you remember that scandal that occurred at West Point? The cadets were expelled for cheating. There was a survey taken saying, what was the single factor in the breakdown of the cadets' behavior? More than half of the cadets said it was the removal of mandatory chapel church. Did you hear me? The removal of mandatory chapel church. The cadets felt sanctity was driven out of the moral code. Ceremony and sanctity are closely related, and baptism reminds us of our humanness and our dependence on God. It is an act of community. It is also an act of contrition. Baptism is also an act of commitment. Whether it is the presenting of a child at the altar or the commitment of our own lives, baptism is first step toward a new life. Baptism does not mean that we have arrived, but it does mean that we are getting started. Baptism was Jesus' first act when he began his ministry. When we seek to begin a life new in Christ, we begin with Christian baptism as well. The word baptism and resurrection of Christ. Jesus called his death and resurrection baptism. There is a baptism with which I must be baptized, and how great is my anguish until it is accomplished. Luke 12, verse 50. It is just a ceremony, but what a significant ceremony it is. Baptism is much more than that. It signifies all that God has done for us in Jesus Christ. It is the first outward expression of new life in Jesus Christ. It is the heart of every Christian's walk with God. And it is available to all who confess their faith in Jesus Christ.
Brothers and sisters, as a reminder of our identity, we make our communal confession of our faith. I confess. Oh, we start again. There you go. I believe,
Father Almighty,
maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father for all ages. God from God, light from light, true God from true God,
begotten,
not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made, for us
and our salvation.
He came down from heaven.
By
the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death, scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Trusting in God's providence, we turn to him and provide our needs for today.
For the church, that we may recognize our calling to be daughters and sons of God and empowered by the Holy Spirit, manifest God's love and compassion through our words and deed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For understanding, that we may learn from Jesus how to be fully human and place all our gifts and talents into God's service, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For a deepening of prayer in our lives, that like Jesus, we may grow in our relationship with God through prayer and listening, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have been baptized in our community, particularly those during this last year, that they may be faithful disciples of Jesus and continue to grow in their knowledge and love of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have responded to God's call to minister, that God will strengthen them, make fruitful their service, and empower them with the Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have experienced abuse or discrimination, that they may hear God's affirmation that they are beloved and experienced healing for their bodies, minds, and spirits. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who are sick, that God will heal those who are ill, bring an end to the COVID pandemic, and sustain all who care for the sick. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us gathered here today and the intentions we hold in our hearts, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Merciful and loving God, you invite us to look at your Son and see that you're well pleased. We turn to Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Our offertory hymn can be found in the blue book, number 572. Baptized in water, number 572 in the blue book. baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting his promise, faith.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we've received the bread we offer you. For of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. For of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. Accept, O Lord, the offerings we have brought to honor the revealing of your beloved Son, so that the oblation of your faithful may be transformed into the sacrifice of him who willed in his compassion to wash away the sins of the world, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift
thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for in the waters of the Jordan, you revealed with the signs and wonders of a new baptism, so that through the voice that came down from heaven, we might come to believe in your word dwelling among us, and with the spirits descending in the likeness of a dove, we might come to know that Christ, your servant, has been anointed with the oil of gladness and sent to bring the good news to the poor, so that with the powers of heaven, we worship you constantly on earth and before your majesty. Without end, we acclaim.
Holy. Heaven and earth are full, of your glory. Hosanna,
Hosanna,
Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time that he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread. Giving thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Michael, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed apostles, and with all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. In him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power,
and the glory are yours,
now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit. Let us offer each other a sign of Christ's peace. Peace be with you, Father.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Our communion hymn can be found in the blue book, number 349, Come to the Water. Number 349, Come to the Water. Let all who thirst, let them call to the water, and let all who except for the Lord. And let all who seek, let them call to the water. And let all who have nothing, let them call to the Lord. Without money, without strife, why should you spend your life except for the Lord? Let them come to the Lord, all who labor without rest. How can your soul find rest except for the Lord? And let all the poor, let them come to the water. Bring the ones who are laden, bring them all to the Lord. Bring the children without mind, easy to load.
You know, one of the things that it really inspired me to commit to being an oblate was understanding the significance of what our founder discovered. And so I want to leave you a great moment to remind ourselves of ritual and significance and identity. So I, in my mind, I had this homily prepared because Father Harold told me, just come and don't worry about the homily. In my mind, I thought he said, there's not gonna be no homily, just go through. But to my surprise, you know, I was nourished as well. But I had some thoughts. And this summer I was here and I celebrated Mass with y'all when y'all were doing the picnic. And I shared something. There's something different going on here because you accepted us oblates with our quirkiness. And we accepted you with yours. And that's the beauty about the body of Christ. So our founder decided that he never celebrated his birthday anymore. He celebrated his baptism. Do you remember when you were baptized? Do you remember the date? Do you remember the month? Do you celebrate that? Or does it have no relevance in our lives? It's a good mindfulness about it. I was lucky. I was baptized a month after I was born. these Mexicans, you know, they have this whole thing of ritualizing things. So that happened to me, so I know I was in May of 1977. But it's a reminder. And so Bishop Barron had a great homily. If you want to go into deep priest, prophet, and king, it's a great thing. But I leave you with this last thought, I promise. We oblates have a certain way of working. Some people don't understand it, and some people do not like it. But our founder understood this, and we believe in this. We are called to be fully human. We are called to be deeply Christian. And we are called to live fully our sanctity. And fully human looks very different for everyone. Fully Christian looks different, but it's the same spirit. And living our sanctity, that means we are set apart. We know we're set apart for something greater than ourselves, something that God prompts us. So I invite you to consider, if you haven't seen when you were baptized, go home, look through your records, pray for your family, pray for those who are your sponsors or your godparents, because my godparents were my own grandparents, and I don't recall anything of them teaching me really a lot about the faith. So I pray for them, because maybe in their busyness they forgot. I don't know. But as a people of faith, we have a sketchy history anyway, so they're just part of the history too. So have a wonderful and blessed Sunday evening today, and enjoy your baptism identity. Let us pray. Nourish with these sacred gifts to your only begotten Son, we may be your children in name and truth. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Any announcements? Because I saw the sign outside, that's why.
Coffee and donuts will be held Woo-hoo! After Mass in the gym today. Faith formation class resumes this Sunday. And the men's club barbecue has been postponed. And the men's club for this week is canceled.
And in substitution for that, you have a few rosaries and a few prayers. So please enjoy. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you and keep you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Our recessional hymn can be found in the Red Book. O breathe on me, O breath of God. Number 725 in the Red Book, O breathe on me, O breath of God.